Welcome children, welcome to my geography class today. The lesson for today is Physical Features of India.
On TV, interesting!
India, which is located in the southern part of Asia, is the world's seventh largest country. Today we are taking our viewers to this beautiful country. India is a country of diverse landforms. There are mountains, plains, desert, plateaus, coastlines and islands. The world-famous Noi Mountains of Himalayas are located in the north and are also known as the Northern Mountains in India. Right next to the Northern Mountains are the Northern Plains. These plains are very fertile and are irrigated by the Ganga, Yamuna and Brahmaputra rivers. These rivers flow down from the Himalayas. In the west lies the famous Great Indian Desert, a hot and dry region. It forms a natural boundary between India and its neighbor Pakistan. The Deccan Plateau is located in the southern part of the country. The coastal plains of India surround the Deccan Plateau on both eastern and western sides. Three water bodies, that is the Arabian Sea, Indian Ocean and the Bay of Bengal, also surround the Deccan Plateau on the west, south and east respectively. The Andaman and Nicobar group of islands in the Bay of Bengal and the Lakshadweep group of islands in the Arabian Sea are also a part of India.
Well children, after looking at that video, we know that the physical features of India can be classified into six physical divisions. The first is the Northern Mountains, second, the Northern Plains, third, the Thar Desert, fourth, the Peninsula Plateau, fifth, the Coastal Plains, and last, the Islands. Northern Mountains, a region of lofty snow-capped mountains and deep valleys situated in the north of India. Many freshwater rivers originated here, for example, the Ganga, Yamuna and Brahmaputra. Himalaya. Him plus Alaya means the abode of snow. The Himalayan mountains are divided into three parallel ranges running from the northwest to the northeast of India. Breaking the Himalayas into three, the first of Himalayas are known as the Great Himalayas or the Himadri. The middle part of the Himalayas are known as the Middle Himalayas or the Himachal. And the bottom part of the Himalayas are known as the Shivaliks. The Northern Plains, also known as the Indo-Gangetic Plains. This region is situated to the south of the Himalayas. They are generally level and flat. These plains are formed by the alluvial deposits of the three rivers, the Indus, the Ganga and the Brahmaputra and their tributaries. These river plains provide fertile land for cultivation. This is the reason for high population in these plains. As a result, these plains are also known as the Indo-Gangetic Plains. In this map, the orange marked part shows the Northern Plains. The Ganga Basin makes it perfect for agriculture. Crops found in this area are rice, wheat, jute, and sugarcane. This region is also highly populated. A few cities are Delhi, Agra, Kanpur, Allahabad, Patna and Calcutta. The main occupation is agriculture.
A desert is a barren and sandy land that receives very little rainfall.
Deserts are formed over a long period of time as a result of poor rainfall and soil erosion. Naturally, deserts have very little vegetation. The desert region in India is located around the southwest part of the Northern Plains. The Thar Desert also known as the Great Indian Desert, is located in western Rajasthan and covers a major part of the state. Rajasthan is also known as the desert state of India. The Aravalli Range lies in the eastern region of the desert state. The Thar covers a major part of Rajasthan and extends up to Gujarat, Punjab, and Haryana. Desert as a landform. Deserts do not have much vegetation because of scanty rainfall. Plant life exists only in the form of thorny shrubs and herbs, cacti, date palms, kikar, and babul, etc., that do not need much water. Lack of vegetation also causes soil erosion and dust storms. Strong winds that blow in deserts carry sand over long distances and form sand hills. These go up to even 500 meters high and are called sand dunes. Water and vegetation in deserts. Deserts also have oases, areas in a desert where there is water and plants. We see many date palms, shrubs, herbs, and some vegetation in oases. Naturally, there are human settlements around oases.
Crops such as bajra, jowar, maize, sesame, and groundnuts are grown in summers, while wheat, mustard, rye, and cumin seeds, jeera, are grown in winters.
Irrigation. The Indian government has greatly helped Rajasthan tackle the problem of water shortage by way of a big canal called the Indira Gandhi Canal, also known as the Rajasthan Canal, which brings water from River Sutlej to Rajasthan. The 500 kilometers long canal provides water to northwestern Rajasthan, Ganga Nagar district, as well as parts of Bikaner district. The canal has helped the people of the desert state to tackle water shortage faced in households and farms too. More and more land is now being brought under cultivation. Wheat, maize, jowar, bajra, cotton, pulses, and sugarcane are also grown here now. The Indira Gandhi Canal also supplies drinking water to thousands of people living in the interiors of the Thar Desert region. Climate. The Great Indian Desert receives poor rainfall and is very dry and sandy. It has an extreme type of climate, very hot summers and very cold winters. The sand gets very hot during the day and cools down very fast at night. This is why it becomes very hot during the day and very cold at night in the Great Indian Desert. Animal life of the Thar Desert. The Great Indian Desert is home to black bucks, partridges, chital deer, the Great Indian Bustard, wild cat, etc. These animals are able to withstand the typical conditions in deserts. The camel is a major mode of transport in deserts because it has the unique ability to go for days on end without food or water. Its padded feet and strong legs help it go across deserts. Camels are also used for carrying heavy loads across long distances. Life and occupation of people living in deserts.
As we have seen, people living in deserts have to face difficult conditions, especially with regard to the climate, food, and water.
Most people in deserts do not live in fixed settlements, but keep moving from place to place in search of food and water for themselves and their animals. They are called nomads. Rearing of sheep and goats is an important occupation of the people of Rajasthan. Some nomads also make a living as blacksmiths by making pots and pans, iron tools, and other useful things made of iron. A group of people traveling together on camels form a caravan. The pagri, that is the turban, angarkha, dhoti, pajamas, kamarband or patka, that is the waistband, form an integral part of a Rajasthani male's attire. Rajasthani women wear ghagra, that is long skirt, kurti or choli, that is tops and blouses respectively, and odni. They use shoes known as jutis or modris, created from sheep, goat or camel skin. The tribal women of Bhil, Gairi and Meena wear various types of jewelry made of brass, silver and lead.
Peninsula Plateau. A peninsula is a land form which is a large and raised area of flat land, almost like a table. It is triangular in shape and is also called tableland. It is a landmass covered by water on all three sides. It extends from the south of the North Plains to the Kanyakumari in the southernmost tip of India. It is divided into two parts, the Narmada River, the Central Highlands and the Deccan Plateau. If you see this map, you will notice that it has pointed out the Central Highlands, the Deccan Plateau and the Western Ghats. The Central Highlands consist of the Malwa Plateau and the Chota Nagpur. Rivers found in Narmada, Chambal, Sindh, Betwa and Kin. Alwai Hills, one of the oldest ranges in the world, is situated on the northwest side. The plateau is rich in minerals like coal, iron ore, occupation is mining industries. If you look at the map, you'll notice there's a small spot which is numbered 1, 2 and 3. 1 marks the Central Highlands, 2 marks the Deccan Plateau and 3 marks the Chota Nagpur. Coastal Plains. India is a country that is surrounded by sea on three sides. The coastal plains in India are along the west and the east of the country, which is known as the Western Coastal Plains of India and the Eastern Coastal Plains of India. If you notice the map, you will see at the bottom of the map, you will find the Eastern Ghats and the Western Ghats, which is also known as the Eastern Western Coastal Plains of India. To the Western Ghat and the east of the Eastern Ghat lies in the coastal plains. Like shown in this arrow, you can see the Western Ghats and the Eastern Ghats, which lies at the coastal plains. There are number of eastern flowing rivers, the Himadri, Krishna, Godavari, Kaveri, drains into the Bay of Bengal. Deltas of the river Mahanadi, Krishna, Godavari, and the Cauvery are present in the eastern coastal plains. The Sundarban Delta is formed where the Ganga and the Brahmaputra flow into the Bay of Bengal. The eastern coastal plains stretches from the West Bengal to the north of Tamil Nadu to the south and passes through Andhra Pradesh and Odisha. The deltas are very fertile and productive for agriculture. Therefore, the delta of the river Krishna is called the Granary of South India. The western coast is again divided into three categories: Utkal Coast, Andhra Coast, and Komandal Coast. Western Coastal Plains of India. Western Coastal Plains stretches from Kerala in the south to Gujarat in the north, passing through Karnataka, Goa, and Maharashtra. The Western Coastal Plains stretch for 1500 kilometers north to south and its width ranges from 10 to 25 kilometers. This place is rich in oil. Along the Malabar coast, there are many beautiful lagoons, which makes this place a tourist destination. The western coast is first divided into four categories: Kanch and Kathiawar coastal, Konkan coast, Karnataka coast, and Malabar coast. The main occupation of the western coastal plains are fishing, tourism, and agriculture. Ghats, two mountain ranges forming the eastern and the western edges respectively of the Deccan Plateau of Peninsula India. The two ranges run through parallel of the Bay of Bengal and the Arabian Sea coast respectively, from which they are separated by strips of fairly level coastal land. Delta. What is a delta? Delta is an area of flat land shaped like a triangle where a river divides into small rivers as it goes into the sea. As a child, we have all heard about stories which take place in islands. So what is an island? An island is a piece of land which is surrounded by water on all four sides. The famous islands are the Andaman and the Nicobar Islands. Are a group of islands situated near the Bay of Bengal. The southernmost point is called the Indra Point. The climate in this island is pleasant. It is neither hot nor is it cold. Port Bihar is the capital of this union territory. Rice, rubber, banana, and coconut are widely grown here. Lakshadweep Island. This is another island which is located near the Malabar coast in the Arabian Seas. It is a group of about 36 islands. Rice and coconuts are the main crops grown here. Fishing and agriculture is the main occupation of both these islands. Well, children, this is the end of our lesson. Thank you.